Hello there. In this video, we are going to make an applique design based on an existing free font. Now, I did this a few weeks ago with a serif font, and I got the letters, downloaded the font for free, brought it into Embrilliance, and then we created Mama. The difference with that example is that those letters are serif letters, and they were not designed to connect to one another. If we're working with a script font, we want those letters to look continuous, so it'll be one continuous shape. So the first thing we need to do is to get the font. Now I'm going to head over to defont.com, and I am going to be using Pacifico. This is a free font. It's in the public domain. I go ahead and click download. Now when you download it, it's going to be a zip file. And you can see I downloaded it a few times. If I look at that file, on a Mac it automatically extracts. You might need to double click on it to get it to extract the files. Then all you need to do is double click on the TTF or the OTF file, and then it will be available for use for this kind of an activity in Embrilliance. Now, sometimes, excuse me, you will not see that font right away. And I actually just experienced this when I restarted my computer, those fonts showed up. So I've already installed Pacifico just by double clicking on it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into create mode, which I'm in right now. And I'll see this little button right here. Now this is different than creating type or words with digitized fonts. What we're doing is we're gonna make a word and it's gonna turn into an outline. So let's go find that Pacifico font that I installed. And again, if you did this and you installed your font and your font is not there, just restart your computer. And I'm just gonna type my name. Okay, it's pretty small. I see that my design is 1 3/4 by 1, so I'm gonna stretch it out a little bit. And it's gonna be overall about 7 inches wide. Well, this is actually a pretty good example because my letters are already overlapping. My J is not, and I want that to overlap. So I am going to nudge that over there. Now, these are all separate shapes, and I want them to be one continuous shape. If you have StitchArtist Level 3, then you can do this trick. You can take the two letters you want to merge together. So in this case, let's take the J and the U, and I'm going to shift select them. And I'm going to choose this little button right here, which is a union. And now you can see I have a J, a U, and a JU. I don't need the J and the U anymore. Oops, I accidentally deleted something I didn't want to delete. Let's delete the J, let's delete the U, and now I have the JU as one shape. We can continue doing this so that we have just one big word. I'm gonna keep unioning. And this little dot on my I, I'm not gonna make that a union, but the E we want to connect, so I'll continue to union. And now I can get rid of everything except this last shape right there. Now those are a lot of control points, and we may not need so many control points to define the shape. Obviously we can go in and manually delete excess points and maintain that shape, you know, kind of be judicious about it. But in Embrilliance, you also have a utility. Let me see if I can find it here. Create outline, reconstruct outline. And do you see how that greatly simplified the number of control points? I probably can manually get rid of a few more, because the more control points, the more it's gonna wanna put down stitches and it gets too dense in spots. So you wanna have minimal control points, you know, use the minimum of what you think you need. So in any of these areas where we see these points very close together, we can get rid of them. Now, what we need to do is we need to apply an applique stitch to it. Now that is a blanket stitch, and so you might be interested in something a little bit more traditional, so like a satin stitch applique. And that is how we build an applique file from a TTF font that we can get for free. If we want to have three levels of applique, oh, that's a fabric preview, I'm sorry, meaning we want to do a stitch line for the position, a stitched out line to tack down the material, and then a final satin stitch, you want to make sure that you have both of these buttons checked right here. So I hope you found that to be useful. So I'd love to see what you do. Thanks. Subscribe to the channel and feel free to leave me some feedback. Thanks. Bye.